This is Dr. B, and we're going to take a look at three ways to make a one molar solution of hydrochloric acid. So let's open the hydrochloric acid up and get started. The first way, just to use a recipe. So often when you buy the hydrochloric acid, you get concentrated hydrochloric acid. It has a recipe how to do it. So I'm looking here. This is Flynn Scientific, and this I actually got online. Hydrochloric acid. If I have concentrated hydrochloric acid, it's right about 12 molar, I need to have 83 milliliters in 1 liter in order to make that solution. So here's how we do that. So we get our 1 liter volumetric flask, and we add some water. We add the water because once we add that concentrated hydrochloric acid here, it can get kind of hot. So we want to have enough water in here to cool that. So we swirl that around, and then we're going to add water up to the mark here. So we want it so the meniscus comes right up to the mark there. So we have it just like that there. That's a one molar solution of hydrochloric acid. Here's another way that we can do this. So we know from the bottle that we have a 12 molar solution of hydrochloric acid. That's the concentrated hydrochloric acid. We don't know what volume we want to add to make 1 liter, but we do know that we want to have a one molar solution and we want to have 1 liter of it. So now we just need to solve for V1 here. Divide both sides by 12 molar. Molarity cancels out. We're left with liters. So basically V1 equals 1 divided by 12. The units will be liters. That gives us 0.083 liters. We can convert that to milliliters by multiplying by 1,000, and we get 83 milliliters, just like the recipe tells us. This is really helpful because we can use this equation in a number of ways. Let's say, for example, so we have our 12 molar hydrochloric acid. That's the concentrated. We don't know how much we need if we want to make, say, 0.5 molar. And let's say we want to make 250 milliliters. So now we divide both sides by 12 molar. Molarity cancels out. And V1, that equals 10.4, the units are going to be milliliters. So we put some water in our flask, we put 10.4 milliliters of concentrated hydrochloric acid, and we bring it up to the mark, we have our solution. The third way you could do this, instead of 12 molar, you could get a stock solution, say 6 molar, and just go through the same calculations to figure out the volume. That's it. This is Dr. B looking at three ways you can make a 1 molar solution of hydrochloric acid. Note that some people do work with specific gravity and density to do this, but I find these three ways are the easiest. Thanks for watching.